All right, so here we go, we back. All right, so I got my meat in here, okay? I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna cut this cabbage up. I'm gonna get this started. Cut my cabbage in half like this, okay? Boom. Whenever you hear somebody say, man, I'm gonna blow your cabbage, This is why they mean that, man, because when they blow your brains out, your brains look like this already. And when you cut the cabbage in half, it look like brains. So, all right. We're gonna julienne this up real quick. Good old knife, J.A. Henry. I'm gonna use a different knife for that. Here we go. This is a sword. Sharpen it up a little bit. Remember, I told you, it doesn't matter how hard you do it. Alright? And actually, I prefer you not to do it hard. I prefer you just lay the blade onto the sharpener. And I said I was going to tell y'all the name of this piece, but I'll tell you later. But anyway, I prefer you just lay your blade on there, man, and go across it gently, and make sure you go down with it and across, man, because you want to catch the whole blade, the whole knife. Alright? Alright? Make sure you wipe it off after you do so, man. Alright? Reason being, shavings being on, man, and I will show you this now, but anyway, you got your shavings on here, you don't want that on your food. Kind of shaving it a little bit. Alright, the pieces at the bottom, they were getting a little thicker. Alright. I'm back here towards the stem, the stalk. You'll want that because the stalk is kind of bitter. Alright. This is beautiful. I like to get the most I can out of my anything that I'm cooking or dealing with. So now this is what I'm doing. Chopping that bad boy up nice and fine. Because see, this is part of your filler. Alright? This is part of your filler. Get all that together. It's okay to do it like this, yo. I recommend it. Or you can put it in one of those ninja blenders that I have behind me. Alright? I just wanted to show you guys my knife skills. Okay? You hear that good old music? known. So we julienne the cabbage and then we dice the cabbage, alright? It's just easiest that way. Alright. You don't want huge pieces in there, alright? But it's okay to have a little, for it to be a little chunky. Big pieces like this, you don't want, alright? But if you got a piece, like, like that right there, those two pieces, gotta cut them up, man. If it's like that, it's fine. Alright?
Your red onions over here, okay? You got your turkey meat here, ground turkey, and then you got your rice right here. We're gonna mix that up. All right, so anyway, we're gonna mix that up.
And then we're gonna stuff our cabbage. Now, this has no dairy or any of the things, any of the other items that I named to you that I cannot have. So if any of you that have allergies, like myself, major allergies, this would be a good thing to use. Alright? I'm gonna mix this up real good, yo. Yep. Now that rice, the seasoning from the rice kilo, it's gonna complement this turkey. You understand? You don't need to add much seasoning to this turkey meat. Alright, now, you gotta be moderate with the salt, okay? When you're dealing with this, and you're dealing with cabbage, anything that can bring water to it, you wanna kind of watch the seasoning, but be a little heavier than usual, because the water from the vegetable is actually gonna saturate that seasoning and overpower it. And you don't want that. Alright. So we're about to get down to the nitty gritty of. Now they do not have to be perfect. I have to tell you that, alright? It's gonna be delicious either way it is, alright? So as you can see, I got my ninja stuff ready. I'm
gonna get my cabbage out of my ninja. I only had it in here to store it. You know what I mean? I didn't want to leave it out, you know, and I didn't want to chill it. I don't want this cabbage stiff at all. Okay? I want it flexible. I need it loose. I'm gonna stick that in here because once I do the cabbage, I put the cabbage in here, I do not want it to be soaking in its own juices, right? I kind of want my cabbage to be juicy now, but not greasy. Let me change that, all right? I don't want it to be greasy, so that is why I put this in here, okay? What I want from here, I want all the nutrients out of the cabbage, and I want the protein for the meat, but I do not want the grease. That's the fact. I don't want that. I'm already kind of, woo, little hefty. Y'all follow my journey, man, on Facebook, man. My name is Ray Lewis on Facebook. Find me, man. I got a journey going on there with my weight loss. I'm trying, y'all. Hard. So again, like I said, you see pieces like this, they do not have to be perfect. Alright? So I'm gonna take this, this is just as simple as possible. Now not too much, but enough. Alright. You see that? Well, you see that there. Alright, so what we're going to do now, we're going to take it, we're going to take this bad boy, it's a little stiff, okay, not going to be perfect, if you're looking for perfection, don't watch me. So anyway, I'm going to fold it here, I'm going to fold it here, okay. Then I'm gonna take it, pack my meat in, pack your meat in if you want to. Alright, you're gonna take it, you're gonna fold it here, and you're gonna roll it. Okay? Don't worry about it being perfect. This is how it looks. Alright? Now, certain pieces are gonna be better than others. That's fine. You get the point. You understand? Alright, let me show you something. So you got this piece here. What I'm telling you, the certain pieces are different than others. Alright. Pack that up like so. Alright. A little more now. Look here. Wrap that bad boy up like so. This is a perfect wrap. Just so you see what a perfect wrap looks like. Alright, it's okay if it doesn't look like this. Alright? If you look the way I got it in here, man. Alright? If it looks the way I have it in here, then that's fine. You know what I mean? That's not gonna do any different. When it cooks, the meat's gonna shrink, it's gonna reduce. And when the meat reduces, the cabbage is going to reduce right along with it. So regardless of the fat, man, if it looks that way, it's going to end up to be what I just showed you. All right? You're just going to have that one opening on the side. You feel me? That's it. It's going to still retain its juice. It's still going to be moist. Throw that bad boy up like that. You feel me? Now, if they do happen to be a little more stiff than you want it,
And all you gotta do is put it back in some hot water and get it to where you like it, man. You know, but make sure it's not too soft, right? You don't want that. This is only going to fit about 6 inside this pan right here, which is fine. That's more than enough that I need. The rest of this, the filling, I'm going to show you what we're going to do with that at another time, all right? But, like I told you in my other segment, I don't throw away all the communications company. And my number one motto is, I do not throw away any hardware. I take that same attitude to the kitchen. Everything's useful, or can be reused. That's a good one, that's a big one. That's a big one. So, how y'all doing? Me? Doing great. As long as I got God, I got this food, I'm all right. I got my family, I'm all right. I'm good to go, babe. I might lay some on top of each other, you know. Let's see what happens. I think it might be, feels like a passy, but I think I can get it. Y'all. I'll make it work. All right. See what we can do with this here. Now, don't be shy to be rough with the cabbage. It's okay. Sometimes the cabbage likes it rough. You feel me? All right, so here we go. Pack it up. Not too much, but just enough. Remember, it all reduces. All right. I did not put any smart balance in here, by the way, just in case if anybody was asking or wondering. Nah, I put everything. What you saw, what I did, is exactly what I did. What's up, buddy?
If there were two ovens,
and it was just Jaylen's, or? Probably just Jaylen's. All right, guys, so this is what I have here. Beautifully wrapped. All right. Now we're gonna go ahead and throw it in a ninja.
Oh, can I get some water?
Wait.
So
we're gonna throw this in a ninja. We're gonna leave it in there. We're gonna let it bake for about 20 minutes, and we're gonna put it at the temp of 250.
It's about time you picked up.
So it'll be 250 for 20 minutes. Now, the rest of this, we'll pour it out. I don't need it. Now the rest of this, on the other hand, all right, I'm gonna pack up for a later time. If I wanna make a turkey loaf, I do that. If I wanna do stuffed bell peppers, I use that. If I wanna do stuffed mushrooms, for my wife, you know, I throw some Parmesan cheese in there. I do it that way. And there's a few things I can do with that, man. Nothing is ever really trash, even the bone. You can always make a good bone marrow soup. You can always make a good straight-up bone soup. I mean, you know, there's many things you can do with leftovers, all right? That'll be another segment. I'll show you what we do with the leftovers. So, we'll be back. I'll show you the finished result. Peace.